Welcome to this introduction to the new Kensa Evo model. This model is a replacement for the Kensa single compressor compact units, which have been on sale since 1999. Anyone who was familiar with those models isn't in for any nasty surprises here. Although the unit features a completely new touchscreen control panel, in terms of its installation and connections, it's really very similar to the old versions. We're going to slowly take the panels off and I'll show you all the features and facilities that the new model's got. So I've now removed the front panel, which is a single crosshead screw at the top, and I've removed the inner electrics cover, which is two screws at the front and it just clips off. And that reveals the inner control area where the electrical wiring is. We've brought all the electrical connections right to the top of the machine, so that it's really easy to install. You've got pre-made knockouts in the rear panel to bring the cables through, and there's a whole row of electrical terminals for installation right along here at the front, with the main power connections right here to one side. It's really very easy access and very simple to connect. We've retained exactly the same connection and control philosophy as the old model. Although this can do lots of new things and has got lots of new features, it can be used in exactly the same way as the previous model. So it doesn't need really any learning if you're already an experienced Kensa engineer. The connections of the power, the thermostat control, the hot water control, and the diverter valve remain exactly the same. Even the terminal numbers are the same as the previous model. We've included the option of a second heating set point. This allows the unit to modulate between two heating mode water temperatures by using two separate inputs, possibly one from an area that's heated with radiators and another from an area that's heated with underfloor. Another feature is a secondary heat function that is connected to the hot water cylinder. This allows boost heating or Legionella control to be performed automatically at the end of a hot water heating cycle performed by the heat pump. Another feature that's on the board is a pump stop function. This allows an external heating pump to be stopped while the heat pump is performing domestic hot water heating. Also, we have on board a bivalent control. Although we've not included any bivalent or embedded heaters in the product, there is the ability to control an external heater or boiler in the event that the heat pump isn't making the necessary temperature into the heating system. We've also included in the product a lot of new temperature and pressure sensors that monitor and record various parameters that are taking place within the unit while it's operating. These enable the installer or indeed the end user to read all the temperatures and pressures that are affecting the unit via the digital display. This includes both high and low pressure of the refrigeration circuit and compressor discharge temperatures, meaning you really, as an installer, don't need any extra tools to take a full set of readings from the operation of the heat pump. Also standard with every unit is connectivity. Although at the moment this feature hasn't been launched, it's backwards compatible with all units that are sold now, and in the future should allow remote monitoring of all the functions that I've just been talking about. So I've now removed the front panel and I've also removed the four transit bolts. In a normal installation, it isn't actually necessary to take the front panel off. We've mounted the compressor and heat exchangers on a sub-chassis, and this floats. It's really quite wobbly once you've removed the transit bolts. This is deliberate. It prevents vibration and noise passing out through the case and up the pipes. Also here, you can see the really thick acoustic insulation, which is fully lining the chamber where the compressor and heat exchangers are mounted. We've included flexible hoses within the product, so it's no longer necessary to use flexies when you connect this unit to the plumbing system. All the new Kensa Evo models get an A++ efficiency rating. They're ultra high efficient. But we've not done this by using inverters. When we were doing the research and development for the product, we looked long and hard about including an inverter in the product. But when we analysed it, because of the extremely stable source temperature that ground source heat pumps run at, we pretty much decided that the only advantage of including the inverter was a reduction in the buffering capacity. We found it didn't really provide any significant efficiency gain. Bearing in mind that the product's got a 25-year design life, we decided not to fit an inverter in the Kensa Evo model. That meant we had to work really hard with the heat exchanger and design of the components within the refrigeration circuit to get the high efficiency. But we think in the long term, not having an inverter will be a plus point for the product. By having an A++ efficiency rating, it maximises the RHI return for the end user. Also, within the design, we were able to incorporate heat exchangers that allow us to get 60 degree hot water off the unit without using any supplementary heat. So this is the rear of the unit, showing the flow and return connections to both the ground and the load side. We've used plain Boss 28mm fittings, which allow you to use either compression couplers or push fit, as in the old model. We've got cutouts left and right so the plumbing can come in from either side. Also, we have the option of removing this small top panel, which allows the plumbing connections to come vertically down. The plumbing can simply be pushed on in the fastest way imaginable.